Hey, what's up guys? Will here for GSM Arena. The Moto G10 is an entry-level smartphone, and these aren't really known to be feature-packed. But still, is it a solid offering in its price range? Let's find out in our full review. The Moto G10 is an all-plastic phone, but that doesn't mean that it's boring. It brings an interesting matte, wave-like texture that I haven't seen before. The texture doesn't really help with the grip, but makes the phone feel nicer, and hides smudges too. Moto has also released a similar, but slightly more expensive device, the G30. It looks much more vanilla, and in this regard, I prefer the G10. Something you'll find on both of these phones is a hardware button for summoning the Google Assistant, and you also get a water-repellent coating on the internals. The screen of the Moto G10 is a 6.5-inch IPS LCD with a 720p resolution, and a notch for the selfie cam. This display isn't very impressive. You get decent contrast and deep blacks for an LCD, but the bezels and chin are rather thick, and this low resolution, coupled with a large screen, results in some graininess, which is visible sometimes. The screen doesn't get that bright either. We measured a maximum of just 370 nits, so using the G10 on a sunny day may be a challenge. On top of that, for a little more money, the Moto G30 brings a smoother 90Hz refresh rate, while the G10's is just the standard 60Hz. For audio, the G10 has a single bottom-firing speaker. It's nothing special, scoring average on our loudness charts, and the quality is just average too. Don't expect much in the way of fullness or bass here. You do have a 3.5mm jack for headphones up at the top. With headphones plugged in, you can listen to FM radio too. The Moto G10 also brings some other popular features, such as expandable storage, and NFC for connectivity and contactless payments. The Moto G10 has a fingerprint reader on the back, and it contains the Moto logo inside. It's reliable to wake up and unlock the phone, but the animation is a bit slow. Under the hood of the Moto G10 is a low-end Snapdragon 460 chipset, which is built on an 11nm process. Overall, performance falls behind the Moto G30 with its Snapdragon 662, though the G10 does alright. It's middle of the road for an entry-level device. We did notice the UI feels sluggish on occasion, but never experienced actual hiccups or stutter. The interface itself is near stock Android 11, with some Motorola features added on top. With the new Android, you get Google's newest features, such as one-time permissions, grouping for notifications, and messaging bubbles. The Moto app is where you can see all of Motorola's customizations in one location. For example, you can personalize the phone with options for icons, colors and font, and wallpapers too. You can activate customizable shortcuts through Moto's gestures, which include things like karate chopping or twisting the phone. And there are display-related features. The attentive display prevents the screen from sleeping while you're looking at it. And the peak display is an alternative to an always-on display, showing you the time and notifications when the phone detects motion or when you pick it up. Powering all of these features is a large 5000mAh battery, and thanks in part to the low-res screen, battery life is incredible here. The G10 was able to score an awesome 152-hour endurance rating in our tests. But charging this big battery takes quite a while. With the bundled 10-watt charger, we were able to go from 0 to only 22% in half an hour. Moving on to the cameras. The Moto G10 has a 48-megapixel quad-bayer main cam, an 8-megapixel ultra-wide camera, a 2-megapixel macro camera, and a depth sensor. One quirky thing about these cameras is the resolution. You have a selector in the camera app which applies to both the main cam and the ultra-wide. So switching to the ultra-wide's native 8-megapixel resolution would force 8 megapixels on the main one too, and vice versa. Expect to go into this menu quite often. Anyway, photos from the main cam taken at 12 megapixels are generally sharp, with a good amount of detail. Shadows and highlights are balanced, and colors are true to life. Portraits are taken with the help of the depth sensor, and these look decent, with natural skin tones and convincing subject separation. Shots from the ultra-wide aren't great, but they're average for this price range. They're soft and low in detail and rather noisy too. At least dynamic range is wide, and the distortion correction works well. Here's a comparison between an 8-megapixel ultra-wide photo and a 12-megapixel one, resulting from that quirky behavior of the resolution toggle. The good news is that the negative effects from the upscaling are hard to notice, but it's only because the images are soft anyway. Close-up shots taken with the macro cam are hit or miss, literally, since this camera doesn't have autofocus. The colors are kind of dull, and the detail level is about what you'd expect from 2 megapixels. In low light, photos from the main camera are far from impressive, typical at this price. They're soft and underexposed, with narrow dynamic range and washed out colors. Turning on the dedicated night mode results in brighter photos with extra sharpness, more balanced highlights and shadows, and less noise, at the expense of some fine detail. It's definitely a better result with than without, but we've seen better night modes from competitors. Photos taken with the ultra-wide at night are hardly usable. They're extremely soft, dark, washed out, and noisy. There's no night mode available here either. Selfies from the 8-megapixel front-facing camera are decent looking if you have enough light. The subject is well exposed and sharp, and the noise is low. The Moto G30 can record video in up to 1080p resolution with electronic stabilization. Videos from the main cam have okay contrast, plenty of sharpening, and low noise. The dynamic range is narrow though, with clipped highlights and low detail and shadows. Videos from the ultra-wide camera are softer and have even worse dynamic range. So that's the Moto G10. You get a neat design, awesome battery life, clean Android 11, and a decent daylight camera. However, there are plenty of shortcomings too, like the sluggish chipset, the low-res screen, which isn't that bright, and poor nighttime camera performance. These days, you can find for a similar price plenty of competitors which improve upon these issues, and even offer you more features. Or if you wanted to stick to Motorola, you can pay just a few bucks more for a decent upgrade with the Moto G30. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay safe, and see you on the next one.